Molly, because this is kind of like one of my first official day or official days that I could do whatever I want in the 2 weeks that I've been off of work so far. Tuesday right now, this Friday will be 2 weeks, so I'm just trying to go into different stores. The prices went even down, more down on this. Damn, I wonder if I should. I want to sell some of my stuff and upgrade, but. Wow, well, I was looking at that, but that. No, I wonder where that chair is at. See, I don't even know if they even have it anymore. This is the chair I was talking about. This is the one I want to buy. It went down in price too. And I bought it. I mean, I was almost going to buy it like a week ago or 2 weeks ago. It's that chair. This chair right here. Because we had a chair that was very similar to this back in the 80s. We had a chair like this, and I think I'm going to go ahead and buy this one for like, so I could play the Atari in the garage, you know. So I want to buy it. And then even I wonder about this. I had one before in the 80s.
Yeah.
82nd, yeah.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Those are nice, man. They feel comfortable.
Yeah. Got all these scooters and when we speak of electric vehicles like cars, I mean, I think they should leave it to the scooters and bicycles only, you know, because a lot of people I've been hearing about, people are not wanting electric cars anymore. I mean, this totally makes me think of my job. Yeah, totally makes me think of my job right here. Because I used to stop by Costco nearby my job. Yeah. I used to always stop by here to grab a bite. Typically pizza and a soda, you know? Yeah. So this is me. I got the thingy. I'm gonna show you the video. I'm gonna show you the video of me having one of these in the late 80s. Yeah. Molly, this is me walking to the car. This is Costco San Bernardino. So this is kind of like It is indeed my first day, kind of like my first day of being able to do whatever I want to do. I mean, yeah. So my kids are completely out of school now. So yeah, they're completely out now. I mean, so no more. I don't need to give them rides or anything. It's just Jenny Lynn. So yeah. Okay, I parked my car. Molly again. So yeah. So this is me. So I mean, this car, it's been sitting here. I mean, it's been sitting pretty much ever since I stopped working, because I was using this car to go to work and back only. I mean, but now I'm not using it that much anymore. I'm not using the Kia that much anymore for work and back, because okay, so yeah. Anyways, okay, I put the chair in there. So yeah. Anyways. In the car. Now that I'm almost reaching the point where I could go ahead and do full time on YouTube, since I'm gonna have more time now, because it was just in the last week that I was really busy because of my kids. I mean, I was giving rides to my kids to school because they were there for different hours, so I was kind of busy last week, you know, like. But now today it's finally a day where I do whatever I feel like doing. I mean, but now from this point on now, I mean, I'll be able to do whatever I feel like doing, you know. Telling you, I want to do more bike riding videos. I want to do some more videos of bike riding, and especially explore like the area, explore like my old areas, like West Covina and Covina. And talk about it and stuff, blog, and I want to do things like that, but I want to get my Mercury ready for that. I mean, but I'll see. I don't even really have to use a Mercury, but I want to get the car ready though. I'm telling you, me driving a stick shift car. So yeah, right now it's kind of like a summery day. Well, it like makes me think of summer. And then right now, Molly. So yeah, just driving around town, and I just went to Costco. I love to go to Costco. So, and I just bought a little eatery from Costco. Two bakes, chicken bakes, and a cheese pizza. There's one place we like to go to. We like to go to Outback Steakhouse. But it's gotten really expensive to go there, so we're not doing it as much these days. So yeah, this is Hospitality Lane. Just gonna go on the freeway to the 10 freeway so I could go home. Aside from any sort of negativity that's coming out of this layoff and situation, I mean, I'm enjoying my time off. I mean, that's one thing I have to say, that I'm enjoying my time off.
from it all.
So yeah.
Yeah, so anyway, so I do know that I still gotta do the EDD, which I forgot about. The unemployment thing, you know, I forgot about that. I could do that and that'll give me some extra money. But if anything, if anything was gonna happen about my job, or if anything was gonna happen where I just couldn't get a job, because there's a lot of cases that I hear that some people are having a very difficult time finding a job, especially because they're old like I am. I'm 53, and it kind of makes me wonder how the job market is going to be for me, because I always heard stories about, like, some older folks having a difficult time finding a job, or they have a harder time than the young folks. So, but if anything like that was to happen, like, where I just can't get a job, even if, like, for a year, let's say it takes more than a year for me to get a job, if anything like that was gonna happen, we would be okay, because Jenny Lynn's job makes enough money. Although we would have to probably do ramen noodles or something, you know. But I mean, what can we do? What can I do? What can I do if I can't find a job? You know, I mean, it's like not my fault.
Molly, just hanging out in the room. So I'm just sleeping. Yeah. So yeah, I'm just resting it out for right now. Yeah. Don't feel like doing anything right now at this moment, but maybe later on I'll probably just play the Atari or something. So I'm just gonna get up right now. So anyways,
since this phone is kind of like, since this camera is kind of blurred out and not working properly, I want to get a new phone. I want to get another one, you know. But I'm just thinking about getting one of the older ones, you know, like that I could buy for $100. You know, the S9. I had an S9 and it worked really good for $100. I'm thinking about it. And then this one. See, these are what I'm talking about. This chair, this is great for like gaming. If I'm gonna play the Atari, it's like back in the day I had this. We had one of these in the 80s decade, you know. Well, not this, but I had this chair. I had one just like it, like where we would sit down and it's comfortable, really comfortable. And I used to play the Nintendo back in the day, you know. Nintendo system, you know, back in our day. So yeah, I mean, well, I'm gonna go show you that video that I'm talking about having this. I'm gonna show you that video right now. See, here's a video from 1990 when I'm about the chair I'm talking about. I think Cynthia was sitting on it right there, but then I was sitting on it. Like, yeah, that's the chair I'm talking about. See, that's me sitting on that bench. So yeah, see, it's like that's why I got all interested in buying that chair from Costco, because this is what I specifically remember. Yeah, that's the, you know, Raymond's car back in the day, and my Mercury. So see, this is more of that chair right there. See, that's when Heckler was sitting on that chair there. See that chair? See, you know, man, Heckler, and I can remember those days when Hector and Raymond, my cousin, was really into that Nintendo game, that baseball. I don't remember the name of it. See that? Yeah, that's me back in those days, remembering those days. That was 1990, by the way.
something that's happened 24 years ago that reminded me of this chair when I bought this chair. Okay, like that's what I remember when I saw this at Costco. I was surprised to see something like this at Costco. So yeah, telling you. So right now, I just got up out of a nap. And so yeah, I'm just gonna take a ride on that scooter. So yeah. I'm telling you. Well, on my day off, I'm gonna ride the scooter around a little bit. Just for fun. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. So what am I planning to do this week? So right now I'm using the GoPro 8. What do I want to do this week? Tomorrow? Probably just gonna take the day off. I'm talking about like not do anything tomorrow, but if I get bored, then I'm probably gonna go ahead and take the mercury to get it smogged, and maybe go ahead and start thinking about what I could do to start dedicating myself to YouTube. Yeah, probably go through more hobbies, I guess, like get my videos together to put them up on YouTube, like the old videos, and think about other things that I want to do for fun to do with YouTube and stuff. But long term, what I want to do, well, like in the next say 2 weeks or within the next week, I want to go see what I could do about the insurance, about our insurance. I'm gonna go follow that furries. There's furry. I'll follow the furries. Here's furries. So I wanted that things I need to do is to see what I could do about the insurance, health insurance. And then well, definitely what I want to be doing in the next 2 weeks is going to like the West Covina and ride my bike in that area, That's what I want to do. Make videos and things like that. That's what I want to do. So yeah. So my car, I mean, this car has been sitting here for like since I stopped working, you know, like. And then right now I've been using strictly these two cars, Edge for the weekends, and then this one is my Claris, is the one that's been driving this mostly. So yeah. Anyways. So anyways. I'm gonna park the scooter here. Molly. So yeah. So what do I do next? Right now, for the rest of today, I'm probably just gonna sleep it off, or just right now from this point on, I'm probably gonna go into my like stuff, like my files, like all the, getting all pictures out of the cameras and put them in the storage, the car drives, and or maybe I'll just play a little bit of this, the Atari and stuff, and probably just sleep it off. Yeah, so yeah. And then I'll think about what I want to do tomorrow, and so yeah. So well, I don't plan on doing anything with jobs until at least next month sometime. So I just want the whole month off. So anyway, so yeah. Yeah, the other day had to get under the washer and find a clog, as it got clogged up again, and it was that sock that got clogged up in the draining system. Yeah. So this record. So yeah. Tell it. So this is Molly. The next day, June 5th, 2024. Just resting it out again. Yeah. Yeah. So I took a drone flight just for the fun of it. So I'm just resting it right now. Again. Right now it's 11. Telling you. So this is Wednesday anyway. On to my day off again. I just got up out of a nap. So anyways, and then I'm looking for more things to get rid of that we don't need. Like I'm gonna endorse selling this. Well, we have too much of this stuff, you know. This was my mom's. She just gave it to us because she left the mobile home, but we don't need it. I mean, because we have a lot of stuff like that. So, I mean, we took it and we were using it, but then we decided that we just don't really need the extras. So, I have that out for sale, and I'm going to still look for more things to get rid of, even if I'm going to give them away. Some certain things I'm going to give away. But, I mean, sometimes it's hard even to give away a few things. Telling you, so I don't have anything else to get rid of. His Apple computer. You know, I lost all interest in selling off my cameras. You know, I lost interest altogether selling off my camcorders because you can get too many low ballers, but the bigger problem is that the ads I put up is just not getting enough views. It's not getting enough attention, and then
if it's gonna take a long time to sell it, forget it. I mean, I'd rather just not bother. I don't want to even bother. Cause I wanted to upgrade, but I mean, I don't want to bother if it's gonna be too much hassle trying to sell the stuff first and then upgrade it. I mean, then buy the new stuff. So I'm calling it off. I'm just not gonna sell anything. And then about this Insta 360 that I messed up the lens on, I was gonna sell it for like $300 as it was, because these are like $400 when they're new. I decided I ordered the lens to fix it myself. It was $50 for the part. I'm gonna go ahead and fix it myself. I'm just gonna fix it, and then because I can do things like that. So what I decided I'm gonna do, instead of trying to bother to sell it, putting on an ad where I get the very little views on it. I mean, where people aren't even really, where there's no traffic at all on the ad. You know, like I said, it's gonna be hard to sell something when there's hardly any traffic on the ad. But miraculously, though, the truck, though, the F-150 that I had, on the first day that I put the truck for sale, I had like about 350 views on the ad. 350 views. And for the Edge that I'm trying to sell, which I'm not in a hurry for, it's like in 3 days, it's like I had it up for in the ad for like 3 days now, and it only got 50 views. So you see the difference. So you could see like the popularity. The popular items are the things that sell quick and for a decent amount of money. But if it's something that's not very popular, if it's not something that people are looking for, then it's going to be harder to sell. I mean, telling. So I don't really have anything else to get rid of, because I would like to get rid of some things that I don't need. So, but I don't have anything else to get rid of or give away. I don't have anything to give away, because all the stuff I have, including the stuff in the backyard, I have my weights back there. Yeah, I have all of my weights back here, so I don't have any plan for selling them or anything. So yeah. So yeah, I don't need to sell none of this stuff. I just have to fix this. I'm gonna fix this whenever I feel like it. Whenever I have a lot of time now, but I'm gonna fix it only when I feel like it, though. And then, so now I gotta put some things away in here. I'm telling you, I put all that stuff away in here, actually. And then I was trying to sell these extra hard drives too. Trying to sell off these extra hard drives, but no traffic at all in the ads. No traffic at all. And so it's impossible to sell. And then I try to see if I could buy one for cheap. And I cannot find anything less than, like, say, $150 for one of these, you know. Like I said, so forget it. I mean, I'll just use them. I'm using them right now, so. Yeah, the problem here, though, is it's just where you put it for sale, or how you're able to expose your ads. I mean, a car salesman, for an example, has the advantage, because he's got the lot. He has the big lot, and he's got signs all over this place, like, selling his cars, and he has a lot of resources, like offices to do all the paperwork. A car dealer, for that example, will have all that. But if it's like a private party like me, I mean, I don't have all that, all the sources, and I don't have all the resources to help me sell a car or anything else for that matter. Like, let's say a dealer, or let's say some store, some dealer had the GoPro, for an example. They would have a store, like, where people can walk into it, and if they get well known, then they're gonna have a lot of customers walking through it. So when you get well known on situations like that, when you get well known, you can sell your product for the price it's actually worth. But like when you're not well known, like in my case, like where I'm not well known, I'm talking about like when it comes to sales and things like that. I mean, like people are not gonna see my ads. I mean, they're not gonna see my ads because people are gonna actually look into store ads. Like they're gonna, like if someone is looking for a GoPro, for an example, the first thing that most people do is just go to a store or go to eBay or something, a store, and then they'll want to buy one, and then they often will end up buying a new. And so the last places that a lot of people look in is like eBay. I mean, maybe OfferUp would be the last places that, because like the store is well known for that example, but the ads, I mean, they're the lesser known, so they get less traffic. And so we don't get much luck on selling stuff. Well, anyway, I'm gonna go back inside. I gotta update my storage. That's what I'm gonna do right now. So this week, I'm gonna just take the whole week off doing whatever I feel like doing. Next, I'll just wait till next week to do those certain things that I want to do. So, yeah. Okay, I finished updating all the pictures and videos that I have from my phone and my GoPros onto the storage. So, yeah. Anyways, sometimes I could spend a lot of time doing that. I mean, like extracting all the pictures and videos from the phones and the GoPros to archive them for their archives for the future. So anyways, so right now I guess I'm just gonna go ahead and do other things that's fun to do. So yeah, what time is it right now? Right now it's 2:30 or 2:48 right now. June 5th today. Yeah, it's 5th today. Look at this person. Yeah. Yeah, probably will look like that in 2040. Yeah, probably will look like that, man. Whoever drew that, man, that's pretty accurate to me, if you ask me. So anyway, I guess I'm going to go ahead and do things that I feel like doing. I'm going to weigh myself. I'm going to vacuum this car. Vacuum the edge. Okay, we've already vacuumed the car, so anyway, so that's that. So yeah, anyway, so I'm just here on my day off, or a month off actually, I'm telling you. So yeah. Today, tomorrow, I think I'm probably gonna go ahead and change the oil on this edge right now. I'm gonna go ahead and do that right now. I'm probably gonna go Walmart, get the oil and the filter, and I'm gonna go change it right now. Yeah. So I went ahead and got the oil. And I'm gonna change the oil on this car right now. So yeah. You know, this is how I make it easy to change the oil. I just drive the car up the curb like that, so I can access under the car without having to use a jack stand or a jack for that matter. I mean, that's the easiest way to change oil in a car. Yeah, I just pulled out the plug, and it got me mad because it decided to leak in two different ways. You know, like some of the oil decided to spew out
decided to spew out that way, and some of it decided to spew out this way, and then it made oil filter wrench. You know, it got me so mad because when I pulled out the nut, it's like the oil decided to spew out this way and then some this way, and then making me make a mess over here, man. It really pissed me off when things like that happen, man. So I got the oil filter wrench. Dang it. Yes, mixing it. Oil changes is an extremely messy job, I tell you, man. You know, like the saying says, you know, oil is cheap, engines are expensive. So, I mean, it's always, that's the cheapest way to make an engine last a long time, you know. Keeping the oil changed, you know. I know some of you are probably talking crap about the Fram oil filters, but, you know, I don't care. I just got to put an oil filter in the car, man. I don't plan on keeping this oil filter forever. I change it every 3,000 miles regardless, you know. I put new oil in the car every 3, regardless of what the manufacturer says. Okay, I put the filter on, so I'm ready to add the oil in the car now. Okay, so I just finished the oil change. So now I gotta clean up this massive mess that I made. Oh, I just put dirt all over it, man. So. Now, see oil change required. And I wanna take that off now. For this edge, I'm on here. On this edge, I have to go to information. It'll say 3 warnings, but I mean. Well, I go to, let me see, I go to information, or system check, and then you probably will have to get out of all that. Over here, this is where I could push and hold this. Where do I do this? Well, I was wrong there. On the edge, we have to go to settings, vehicle settings, and then we scroll down. Where do we go here? And then we go to vehicle. And then this is where we could reset the set to 100%, and you press and hold this, and then it'll right there, and then it'll say, so the oil life is at 100% now. So now I gotta check the oil. Because I added 4 quarts, but I know it takes more than that, so. All right, anyway. So, it's like about an hour later. So I finished the oil change. So yeah, right now the sun is setting. So I was playing a little E.T. earlier. And also I was playing the game Vanguard as well. This game, I really loved that game. And specifically in 1986. It's like the peak time that I remember that game, the E.T. Because I remember when I paid like $3 for it at the time in 1986. And I loved that game back in 1986.
I mean, but it's like I heard stories about the game, you know. They say E.T. is one of the biggest flops ever for the Atari, and E.T. was one of the reasons why the Atari demised, why it was the demise of the Atari. Because I don't know what happened. I know that they were in, the makers of this game was in a rush to make this game before the holiday 1982. They wanted to hurry up and make that game, but it came out bad because people complained about being too hard or something. And so with all those copies that they made or something, and they didn't sell them or something. And then I know another big flop of the Atari was Pac-Man, too. Those are two games that made the demise of the Atari, or that's what I think made them bankrupt or something. Because for Pac-Man, the story about Pac-Man is that they manufactured 12 million copies, thinking that it's gonna sell, like, no problem, because they thought Pac-Man was like number one, and they thought it was gonna sell no problem. They're very confident about selling the 12 million that they produced, but they only sold 7 million. From what I heard, I read about this. They only sold like 7 million or something, and so the other 5 million, you know, they got screwed up because they paid a lot of money. I don't know what happened, but they ended up putting all of those extra cartridges in the landfill or something. You know, that's what I heard. And that's what they say. That's the story I heard about that. I mean, and that those are the games that caused the Atari to go bankrupt or something, you know. But it's funny because back in 86, I loved this game, you know. I loved it, despite of how hard some people say it is. It is kind of hard, you know, for the average person to play this. But for me, it was fun. I mean, it was easy. Well, it was a fun game, man. I'm gonna turn it on. See, Atari, the TV takes a little while to turn on, so. Well, with this game, we just have to find the phone pieces in any of these little holes. And then all various icons will do different things when you levitate your head. Like this icon will tell the inspector or the scientist to go home, for an example. Yeah, remembering those days. See, you gotta avoid the scientists because they take you away and then it's kind of a pain in the butt. Yeah, because once they get you, you can't move, you can't escape them until you get to, and then inspector, you gotta avoid him because he'll take away your phone pieces. The object of the game is you have to find the phone pieces. Yeah. And well, here's one. We gotta find three pieces to make a phone. But you gotta avoid this guy though, because he'll take away your phone piece. See as you see it. Yeah. So it's funny because, like, for some reason I was like getting all into 1986. Because that was like a big year for me. Well, it's funny because ever since I got this stereo here in the thrift store, I mean, it just kind of brought me back to 1984 through 86. But particularly like 1986 for whatever reason, you know, like because the records, I mean, it's especially the freestyle stuff, you know, it was especially like things like, you know, this, the Dream Team and this, especially like all of the freestyle stuff. It brings back memories for me on that. I mean,
And then all of a sudden, I'm all buying these records off of disc cogs and stuff. All of this, it reminds me of this, you know, like rumors. Yeah. All of a sudden, I got brought back to 1986. For specifically, in 1984. In 1984 through 86. It brought me back. That's, ever since I got that stereo, I mean, yeah. It's been kind of fun using the stereo in the last, since I found it in the thrift store, yeah. I mean, well, I guess it's, this will be the end of my blog for today. So that's what I've been doing in the last couple of days now. Within the last couple of days. So, yeah. Anyway, so today is June 5th, 2024. And I would say I'll see you on the next video. All right. See you on the next one. Okay.